much like they did 50, 150 years ago, our laws still shape so many aspects of our lives. Whether our kids have clean air and safe streets or not, whether we invest in education and job training and truly focus on the urgent challenge of getting folks back to work or not, whether our sons and daughters who wear our country's uniform get the benefits they've earned or not. See, these are the types of decisions that are made by the folks in our city halls and our state legislatures, by folks in our state houses, in our Congress, and yes, in our White House. And who's responsible for selecting those public servants? Who is ultimately responsible for decisions they make or don't make? We are. That's our job. As citizens of this great country, that is our most fundamental right, our most solemn obligation to cast our ballots and have our say in the laws that shape our lives. Congressman Lewis understood the importance of that right. That's why he faced down that row of billy clubs on the Edmund Pettus Bridge, risking his life so we could one day cast our ballot. As he put it, your vote is precious, almost sacred. It is the most powerful nonviolent tool we have to create a more perfect union. But today, how many of us have asked someone whether they're going to vote? And they say, no, I'm too busy. And besides, I voted last time. Or no, it's not like my vote's going to make a difference. See, after so many folks sacrificed so much so that we could make our voices heard, too many of us still choose not to participate. But let's be clear. While we're tuning out and staying home on election day, other folks are tuning in. Other folks are taking politics very seriously. And they're engaged on every level. They're raising money. They're in constant dialogue with elected officials. And understandably, in the face of all of that money and influence, it can start to feel like ordinary voices can't be heard, like regular folks just can't get a seat at the table. But we are here tonight because we know that simply is not true. Time and again, history has shown us that there is nothing more powerful than ordinary citizens coming together for a just cause. And I'm not just talking about the big speeches and protests that we all remember. I'm talking about everything that happened between the marches, when the speeches were over and the cameras were off. I'm talking about the thousands of hours that people like Dr. King and so many of you spent strategizing in cramped offices late at night. I'm talking about the folks in Montgomery who organized carpools and gave thousands of rides to perfect strangers. Folks who walked miles on aching feet. I'm talking about the volunteers who set up drinking fountains and first aid stations on the Washington Mall, who made 80,000 bag lunches for folks who marched on that August day. I am talking about the tireless, thankless, relentless work of making change. You know that phone calling, letter writing, door knocking, meat planning kind of work? That is the real work of democracy. Now what happens during those quiet moments between the marches? And that is how we carry on that precious legacy we've inherited. By recommitting ourselves to that day-to-day work that has always paved the way for change in this country. So that means being informed. It means following the news, learning about who's representing us and how our government works. Even more important, it means showing up to vote. And not just every 4 years, but every year, in every election. As the great Congresswoman Shirley Chisholm once said, you don't make progress by standing on the sidelines. Active and passionate citizenship engagement is at the core of our democracy. That's the whole Constitution, we the people. And over the past two centuries, so many righteous men and women toiled and bled and sacrificed so that every last one of us could be included in that we. And today, we owe it not just to ourselves, but to them to exercise the rights they fought and died for. So when it comes to casting our ballots, it cannot just be we the people who had time to spare on election day. Can't just be we the people who really care about politics, or we the people who happen to drive by a polling place on the way home from work. It must be all of us. That is our birthright as citizens of this great nation. That fundamental promise that we all get a say in our democracy, no matter who we are, or where we're from, or what we look like, or who we love. So we cannot let anyone discourage us from casting our ballots. We cannot let anyone make us feel unwelcome in the voting booth. It is up to us to make sure that in every election, every voice is heard and every vote is counted. That means making sure our laws preserve that right. It means monitoring the polls to ensure that every eligible voter can exercise that right. The march of our time, marching door to door, registering people to vote, marching everyone you know to the polls every single election. See, this is the sit-in of our day, sitting in a phone bank, sitting in your living room calling everyone you know, your friends, your neighbors, that nephew you haven't seen in a while, that classmate you haven't spoken to in years, making sure they all know how to register, where to vote, every year, in every election. This is the movement of our era, protecting that fundamental right, not just for this election, but for the next generation and generations to come. Because in the end, it's not just about who wins or who loses or who we vote for on election day. It's about who we are as Americans. It's about the democracy we want to leave for our kids and grandkids. It's about doing everything we can to carry on the legacy that is our inheritance, not just as African Americans, but as Americans, as citizens of the greatest country on earth. Now, as you all know very well, continuing to uphold our legacy requires constant and sustained struggle and hard work. It requires never-ending patience and determination.
Hey yo, it's time to get motivated with Gloria Taylor.
A degree in 18 months.
At Miller-Mott, that's all it takes.
But you can take all the classes you need?
Yeah, that's the difference. I don't have to take any classes that I don't need.
That makes sense.
It makes a lot of sense.
So in 18 months, you'll be finished.
Actually, I'll be getting started, making money in my new career.
And I'll be...
just another student facing more debt.
Miller-Mott College. Changing futures. Changing lives.
Greetings, I'm Gloria Taylor, the host of Motivations, the stories of the struggle in between.
And I'm Jamelia Taylor, her daughter. As Motivation comes upon a 6-year broadcast, we've covered many events. Just to name a few, the Stellar Award.
From the Grand Ole Opry House in Nashville, Tennessee.
The originally Award. Launched in 1993 by the Trumpet Awards Foundation.
Community events.
Congressional Black Caucus with President Barack Obama. So keep watching Motivations, Channel 25 Time on the Cable, Saturday and Sunday at 10 a.m.
And Channel 25 Suddenly Cable, Saturdays at 11:30 p.m. Be blessed.